हेलो स्टूडेंट, माइसेल्फ अंतरा घोषाल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ गुरु नानक इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी। दिस इज माय लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन आरएफ एंड माइक्रोवेव इंजीनियरिंग। द कोड इज EC701 एंड दिस कोर्स इज अंडर सेवेंथ सेमिस्टर इन बीटेक एंड इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट। हियर दिस इज माय कॉन्टैक्ट नंबर एंड दिस इज माय मेल आईडी। If you have any query, then you can contact me through mail. Now the course name is RF and Microwave Engineering, and the code is EC701. And the total lectures for this course are 34. Now there are some course objectives for this course. That is, distinguish the RF and microwave spectrum, planar transmission lines and high frequency circuit elements. Second course objective is determine the microwave passive components and scattering matrix representation. And the third course objective is illustrate the microwave tubes, semiconductor microwave devices. And the fourth course objective is justify the microwave application and typical microwave test bench. There are some course outcome. That means after completion of this course, the students will be able to understand the microwave frequency range and their application. Also, they will be able to develop fundamental understanding of the two-port RF network and matching techniques. Learn the scattering matrix for microwave passive components. Understand the microwave tubes and devices along with their fundamental principle of operation. Also, they will be able to learn the microwave measurement techniques. These are the course outcome of this course. There are several modules. There are four modules, and under module 3 there are different topics like microwave tubes, electron beam and field interaction for energy exchange in resonant, that is two cavity klystron, reflex klystron, magnetron and non-resonant, that is TWT and BWO microwave active devices, and typical characteristics and applications of their these type of devices there. Now today we will discuss about magnetron. Now for that, first we have to know what is magnetron. Magnetron is a device that generates high power electromagnetic wave. It is basically a self-excited microwave oscillator. Okay, now also it is known as a crossed field device, because the electric and the magnetic field which is produced inside the tube are mutually perpendicular to each other. Thus, these two fields crosses each other. That's why it is called as crossed field device. Next, what is the working principle? The magnetron is basically a vacuum tube of high power, having multiple cavities. It is also known as cavity magnetron because of the presence of anode in the resonant cavity of the tube. Now the operating principle of magnetron is such that when electrons interact with electric, that is electric field, when when electrons interact with electric and magnetic field in the cavity, then high power oscillations will be generated. And magnetrons are majorly used in radar as being the only high power source of RF signal as a power oscillator, despite of a power amplifier. Okay, it was invented in the year of 1921 by Albert Hall, and however, an important an improved high power cavity magnetron, which was invented in 1940 by John Randall and Harry Wood. Okay, now here we'll discuss how a cavity magnetron works. Here, this is in the figure, the structure of magnetron is shown. First, we have how it works. Before that, we have to know how a magnetron is constructed. In this figure, from this figure, you can see that they are magnetron with eight cavities. There are eight cavities: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. A cylindrical cathode that is present at the center, and a cylindrical block of copper which is fixed axially, which acts as an anode. This anode block is that block is anode, and that anode block is made of a number of slots that acts as resonant anode cavities. These are the cavities, anode cavities. Okay, the space between this, between the anode and the cathode, that is called as interaction space, and the electric field which is present radially, while the magnetic field is present actually in the cavity magnetron. The magnetic field is produced by a permanent magnet which is placed such that the magnetic lines are parallel to cathode and perpendicular to the electric field, which is present between this cathode and anode. And this is a cylindrical magnetron which has a cylindrical cathode of certain length and radius, which is present at the center, around which a cylindrical anode is present, and the cavities are present at the circumference of the anode at equal spacing. The area existing between that call, that is also all this space is interaction space between this anode and cathode, and there is a phase difference of 180 degree between these adjacent cavities. Okay, the cavities will transfer their excitation from one cavity to another with a phase shift of 180 degree. Thus, we can say that if one plate is positive, then automatically its adjacent plane, that if one plane or plate is positive, then automatically its adjacent plate will be negative. And this is clearly shown in this figure. And more specifically, we can say that the edges and the cavities show 180 degree phase apart relationship. Okay, now what are the working principle of magnetron? before that, first we have to know that that total phase shift around the ring. That this is a eight cavities magnet. This magnetron has eight cavities. Now in cavity magnetron has n modes of operation, and this operation depends upon the frequency and the phase of oscillations. The total phase shift around the ring of this cavity resonators, that should be 2n pi, where this n is an integer. Okay, and if phi v, that represents a relative phase change of the AC electric field across adjacent cavities, then phi v equal to 2 pi n by capital N, 2 pi n by capital N, where this n is an integer number, where n equal to 0, plus minus 1, plus minus 2, or plus minus n by 2 minus 1, plus minus n by 2, that n by 2, that means that mode of resonance can exist if n is the even number, okay? And if small n equal to capital N by 2, then phi v equal to pi. That means this mode of resonance is called as pi mode. When n equal to 0, then phi v equal to 0. And that mode is called zero mode. Phi v equal to 0, that mode is called zero mode, because there will be no RF field, electric field, between the anode and the cathode. And this is also called as fringing field, and this mode is not used in magnetron. Now, next is working principle of magnetron. How magnetron works. There are some cases that the excitation of to the cathode of the magnetron is provided by a DC supply, which causes the emergence of electrons from it. Okay, here in this section we will discuss about how magnetron works under the two categories. First, without applying, first one is when RF is not present, and second one is with the application of RF input. Now, first we consider that there is no RF input. Then when magnetic field is zero or absent, that means when the magnetic field is absent, then the electrons emerging from the cathode radially moves towards the anode. And from the figure we can see that. And this is so because the moving electron does not experience the effect of the magnetic field and moves in a straight path. Okay. Now, in a second case, when a small magnetic field is present, then in this case, if a small magnetic field exists inside this interspace region, then the magnetron inside this magnetron, then the electron which are emerging from the cathode will slightly deviate from its path. Here that was the straight path. Here their path is slightly deviated from its straight path. Okay, and this will cause a curve motion of the electron from the cathode to anode, okay, which is shown in this figure. And this motion of electron is the result of action of electric as well as magnetic force over it. Okay. Now next is case 3, when the magnetic field is further increased, then electrons emerging from this cathode gets highly deflected, okay, by this magnetic field, and graze along the surface of the cathode. If we increase the magnetic field more, like beyond the critical magnetic field, then what will happen? But in this case, that when we are increasing some magnetic field, then this causes the anode current to be zero. Value of the magnetic field that causes the anode current to become zero, that is known as the critical magnetic field. Okay, if the magnetic field increases that beyond that critical magnetic field, then the electron will bounce back. Okay, here the electrons are moving like this, but here if we increase more magnetic field beyond that critical magnetic field, then the electron bounces back to the cathode itself without reaching the anode. The reaching of the emitted electrons from the cathode back to its known backheating. That is known as backheating. So to avoid this, the electric supply which is provided to the cathode must be cut off after oscillations have been set up in the tube. That all these cases were under the when RF input is not present. Now next is when the RF field is present. In case of an active RF input, provided to the anode of the magnetron, then oscillations are set up in the interaction space of this magnetron. So when an electron is emitted from the cathode to anode, then it transfers its energy in order to oscillate. Such electrons are called as favored electrons. In this condition, the electrons will have a low velocity, and thus will take a considerably high amount of time to reach from the cathode to anode. And this is shown in this figure. And in second case, another condition arises in the presence of RF input. In this case, the emitted electron from the cathode while traveling and takes energy from the oscillations, thereby resulting increasing the velocity. So despite reaching to the anode, the electrons will bounce back to the cathode, and these electrons are known as unfavored electrons. And this is shown in this figure. And there is another case, that is case 3, when RF input is further increased. Then the electron emitted while traveling increases its velocity in order to catch up the electron emitted earlier, okay, with comparatively lower velocity. So all those electrons that do not take energy from the oscillations for their movement are known as favored electrons. And these favored electrons will form electron bunch. That is the electron bunch or electron cloud, and reaches anode from the cathode. And this formation of electron bunch inside the tube is known as phase focusing effect. Phase focusing effect. And due to this, the orbit of the electron gets confined into spokes. These spokes rotate according to the some fractional value of electron emitted by the cathode until it reaches anode while delivering their energy to oscillations. However, the electrons which released from the region of the cathode between spokes will take the energy of the field and get back to the cathode very quickly. but this energy is very small in comparison to the energy delivered to the oscillations. The movement of these favored electrons inside the tube enhances the field existing between the gaps in the cavity. This leads to sustained oscillations inside the magnetron, thereby providing high power at the output. That's all for how magnetron works. Now next is what are the advantages of magnetron. Magnetrons are highly efficient device which is used for generation of the high power microwave signal, and the use of these magnetrons in radar, which can produce radar system of better quality for tracking purpose. Also it is usually small in size, thus less bulky. And what are the disadvantages? It is quite expensive, and despite producing a wide range of frequency, there exists a drawback in controllability of the generated frequency. It offers average power of around 1 to 2 kilowatts, and magnetrons are quite noisy. Okay, these are the advantages and these are the disadvantages of magnetron. Now what are the application of magnetron? A major application of magnetron is present in a pulsed radar system in order to produce a high power microwave signal. Also they are used in heating application like microwave ovens, so as to produce fixed frequency oscillations. And tunable magnetrons find their application in sweep oscillators. These are the application of magnetron. Now that's all for today. Today I have discussed about what are the construction of magnetron. After that there are different modes, and what are the working process of magnetron, and what are the advantage disadvantage of magnetron, and what are the application. So that's all for today. Thank you. And these are the references of this presentation. Thank you.